is how you socialize. You sat around the table, you talk to each other. For me, I recommend for parents, they get at least once or twice a week, so they hear the news. So I think eating is a really important part of socialization. So I see this overall as a win-win, and I'm hoping that every single child in New York City will take it this way. But I do think that the data analysis is going to make it easier for us to the course that we need to fill up on our side.
So, first of all, this is obviously a huge milestone, so I thought that we would be very interested. My question is more of a side question that I see so much food being wasted because children are, but they have to take three items even if they're not hungry and the food goes in the garbage. And I'm wondering if you've ever thought of some things to do with that food.
This actually comes up with and the reality is that in terms of what even in your own home, food is awful. We're certainly looking for better ways to provide the food in our school lunches or giving kids money for food. But there's always going to be an element to that, and it's not about doing it away because there are certain order of health laws that do not allow that to happen. You think about, you know, when the child doesn't eat something on their plate, have they touched it? Have they just enough? So I think this is all order of health rules that we're very careful about enforcing the way that it is.
Thank you.
Yes.
So there's a press conference yesterday, should be open if you're a part of that effort, to push for legislation to have allow future options in schools, saying that potentially hundreds of thousands of kids are affected by that and aren't eating lunch for that reason. So even if it's free, it is not up to their religious dietary comforts. I know you just added some holidays to the school year, and as that population expands, is this something that the city would consider?
She said it just
now. This way to make the we have to provide that. In terms of the schools being certified, certain things, that will take a lot longer to put in place, but we're moving to actually that treat here. If there isn't a child who doesn't have an option to have other food other than what's been certified, in most cases, it's peanut butter and jelly with their own fields and vegetarian options. So that goes also in when we have some kind of holidays in schools and all those.
Hi, my question is, what about the parents who owe from previous, like last year, they owe bills from the previous year? Is that going to be credited, or?
To some degree, this is in these, but if you give me an email, somebody will try to get back to you.
We have another question for reporters in the room.
I just have a question about how the
I think of the difference between Chancellor Rose, we've started doing a lot of creative things, including, I think one of the things we talked about hydroponics and growing your own gardens. I think many more of our schools now actually have chicken coops and they're looking for eggs. I'd love to see that in almost all our schools, so it's a great concept. And I think also we have the kids who create recommended meals. There is a lot of work that we're trying to do. So, in addition to relatively high standards for all of our products, we also have a test kitchen, and one of the most popular field trips, and you invite all schools to do this, is to come out for a test kitchen and have our students actually participate in the process of tasting different new menu items and giving us feedback on what they like, what they don't like, and we love doing that, we love getting that feedback. In addition, we also have sound and audio of all our schools, which is very important to try to help them.
The concern in the past came has been centered around Title I funding and whether that would be distributed in a different way if the city rolled out universal free lunch. Can you comment at all on whether the city can sort of for Karen, that there won't be a shift in Title I funding?
I would say there are no guarantees, but there's now an army ready to fight for the council. So stay tuned, because once you win on one level, chances are there's a new fight to be fought. So stay tuned, because there are no guarantees.
Can you jump up for a quick photo?
Excuse me?
I want to ask for halal food, because we have a lot of community in Arabic and Bangladesh. I want to ask for halal food.
I can follow up with you.
Okay.
What to talk to?
Don't come and talk. Yeah. They had a press conference for yesterday. Did you know that?
Yeah,
you were there. Okay.
Especially when you have a lot of community here, Arabic.
I just meant I don't want to know.